Hello students, you are welcome to music class for form 3. Today our topic will be black music in a diaspora. First year, when we are doing the musical type, we found that we have 4 coexisting musical type in Ghana here. The first one is traditional music. The second one is art music. The third one is popular music. And the last one is music in the diaspora. When we talk about music in the diaspora, what comes into your mind? Let's find the meaning of diaspora first. Then you understand what meaning. Diaspora means Greek. Diaspora word is from the Greek, means scattered out. So diaspora is also refers to the movement of the population from its original home. Diaspora has come to refer particularly to historical mass dispersion of an involuntary nature, such as the expulsion of Jews from Judea, the fleeing of Greek after the fall of Constantinople, the African transatlantic slave trade, the exile and deportation of Circassians, the displacements of Palestinians in the 20th century, and many others. Today, our lesson objectives are the historical context of African music in the diaspora, the musical type, form, and instrumentation of music that originated from Africans in the diaspora. Historical context. We all know something about the slave trade. Africans were taken to an exile, to another land, to work in the plantation. One unique thing in Africa is our culture. So when they went to the plantation, they carried along with their culture. One of the integral parts of the culture is music. That is why when we are working at home, when your parents are working, even when you are washing, ironing, the music comes to your mind. This type of music, you don't know where it comes from. The time you realize we are making the music without knowing or without hearing it before. So that's happened over there. So the situation and the condition these people were, they start making music to motivate their spirits. However, in every day's work, after the work, their masters assemble them and teach them things. So, once the music is a dynamic, they infuse their Africanism with their new culture. Voice. So they come out with something called rhythmic cry. As they are weeping, as they are crying, it becomes something like rhythm, but it's so present. So it becomes a rhythmic cry. So you hear the as we are doing that, we are also working. So the later they organize themselves and put it into music. So you just imagine the type of music that will come out of depression, out of duress, duress, what type of music that will come. The music is so sad, melancholic, and spirited one. So when these white people hear the type of rhythm and the music that these people are making it in the plantation, the name is spiritual. This is a spiritual music, but they attach their color to it and become Negro. So the Negro means what? Black. So this type of music came to exist. So wherever they meet, they make a music to motivate and encourage themselves. And this type of music, that the first musical type that emerged was named after their color, Negro, and because it's spirited, Negro spiritual. Let us look at the characteristics of this musical type. Always the lyrics or the texts are from the Bible. And it's an a cappella style, which means that there's no accompaniment. Because you are working. Whilst you are working, who will play a drum for you? No, there's no accompaniment. The rhythmic structure is mostly on pentatonic scale. And you know pentatonic scale from last year. Pentatonic scale is a scale of five, which have no hot, the fourth and the seventh, which means that there's no fa and there's no hot T. When you look at the form, it's always like a binary form. You know the binary form. And a few of them are also in the ternary form. We talk about the rhythmic structure. It's not harmonized. It's normally and mostly in unison. Once a while, you see the interlocking tenses that falls into. Let's listen to this excerpt. In fact, the traditional Negro spiritual has no accompaniment, but this one, because of modernity, they have added some instrument to it. You forget about the instrument type and listen to it. Some of the examples are row your boat, gently down the street, swing low, swing carrots, soldiers of the cross, and many others. We are all Negro spirituals. Boys, can you identify some of the rhythmic structures in this song, Heaven is My Hope? Now let's analyze this more. Listen to the words of it. It's a word of encouragement. Heaven is my hope. So whatever it will happen, I will go and enjoy it over there. So that calms the Negro spiritual. When you hear it, it motivates your spirit to become spirited. You know, boys, in every room there's an exception. Whilst they are meeting, doing service here and there, always God, always God, always God. Don't remember. When somebody stresses you too much, either you obey or you also hurt, revoke or retaliate. So it reaches a certain stage. Some wise people name them stubborn. They are not stubborn, but they want their freedom. Also decided that this time around, after hard work, we will never go to church. And more so, when you are doing your service, we will come and hurt, disturb it. So when they assembled during the service, these guys goes round, find anything they laid hand on, discarded bottles, empty cans, trees, you just name it. And they started making noise. But The noise they are making is too rhythmic and very pleasant. So when these masters come out, hey, what are you doing, you people doing? He said, oh, shut up, we are just making noise. What's the meaning of just making noise? But this noise is not just making noise. It's the sound is so pleasant. Then it came a time. These people decided to develop it because it's come to exist. So it all came about when the slave became fed up of distress, but treatment and others. Some of the stubborn boys decided not to go to church, but would disturb the service. These boys went out, organized themselves, finding some discarded empty cans, bottles, everything they laid around to create a music. However, their intention is what? To disturb the service. So when the masters come out, what are you doing? So we are just making noise. And this just is an adverb of just, J-U-S-T. And because of an American slanted phrase, jazz, it became the name for this musical type. Boys, let's create a music for them now. We are for the jazz, one of the elements is improvisation. So I'm giving the timeline. Give me the timeline. Boy, play anything you want. Thank you, boys. Now, look at the characteristics of jazz. It is a type, it has a timeline which serves as an ostinato. You hear the first one. And the second characteristic is full of improvisation. But play anything you want. So, it's full of improvisation. Play anything nonsense you can. Play, but make it rhythmic to fall into the tempos. And jazz music is full of what? Instrumental. It is a suit, musical suit. It's instrument alone, no vocal counterparts. And normally, because it's from African, and the African people who are performing it, they take their folk rhythms and infuse it with their popular music over there. And we have something which is so common, which is the vibrato shaking and wumbling. That type. There's always one instrument also playing solo. Now, let's listen to this jazz music. Boys, you hear it. They know a lot of jazz music and listening to it. We have the instruments for jazz music. This one is electronic piano or grand piano. This is guitar, bass guitar, and the lead guitar. We have a set of jazz drum. Then we have the muted trumpet. Then trombone and the saxophones, alto and tenor saxophones. These are the basic instruments we use for jazz. So when you look at the timbre of the jazz, it's too hot, heavy, because the instruments are many and everybody is playing improvisation, playing whatever it will suit and make it so hot, beautiful. Thank you boys for the today lesson. The composers, the prominent people known in the jazz music are listed here. We have Jerry Roll Morton, who's a very prominent on piano, Freddie Kimpond, cornet, Kid Oris, trombone, King Oliver, cornet, Duke Ellington, the popular composer and the pianist, Lil Armstrong, pianist Bob Doss and his brother John Doss, drum and the clarinet, respectively. Boys, as we just listened, this is your assignment for the week. Identify three major musical instruments from the excerpts you just hear. The second one, state and explain two characteristics of jazz music you just hear. Thank you, and we shall meet again.